अव्वल पाकिर जैनुलाब्दीन अब्दुल कलाम, इंडियाज मिसाइल मैन, भारत रत्न, ग्रेट साइंटिस्ट, एन एक्सेप्शनल टीचर एंड इंडियाज 11th प्रेसिडेंट. एपीजे अब्दुल कलाम वॉज वन अमंगस्ट द मोस्ट रिस्पेक्टेड लीडर्स ऑफ इंडिया. Popularly known as People's President, Dr. Kalam lives in the hearts and minds of every Indian. Remembering him on his 87th birth anniversary, Prime Minister Narendra Modi described him as a wonderful motivator and a great president. The Government of India awarded him with the nation's three highest civilian honors. Padma Bhushan in 1981, Padma Vibhushan in 1990 and Bharat Ratna in 1997. He became distinguished scientist in the world of rocket, who raised India to the great heights of space science. He was the man behind the development of missile capable of hitting targets as far as thousands of kilometers. The credit for making India known as atomic power in the world goes to him and his fellow scientists. His journey started from a village of Rameshwaram in Tamil Nadu, where he was born on October 15, 1931. Coming from a very humble and hand-to-mouth family, the Indian scientist started to sell newspapers. Not just he sold it, but also read the newspapers even before dropping them to his first customer's house. The reading habit had filled his life full of dreams. Dreams to be someone remarkable. Dreams to do something great for the nation. In 1947, when India got freedom, APJ Abdul Kalam's hopes to fulfill his dream got wings. A free India gave hope to his dreams. During his childhood, Kalam was pleased to see rising waves of sea. He stared at the swans flying over the vast expanse of sea. The idea to fly in the sky sent strange waves of joy to his heart. He saw the dream. One day I shall fly like birds in the sky. To achieve his dream, he studied physics first, then aeronautics. He fulfilled his dream of flying when he piloted a Sukhoi 30MKI Flanker Mach 3. He became the first head of state to fly a fighter plane. He specialized in aeronautical engineering from Madras Institute of Technology. He joined the Defense Research and Development Organization, DRDO, as a scientist. In 1969, Dr. Kalam was transferred to the Indian Space Research Organization, ISRO. His decade of hardship carved the pathway for India to develop its first satellite launch vehicle, SLV-3, which successfully deployed the Rohini satellite in the near-Earth orbit in July 1980. The efforts put in by ISRO welcomed India to the International Space Club. After working for 2 decades in ISRO and mastering launch vehicle technologies, Dr. Kalam took up the responsibility of developing indigenous guided missiles at DRDO as the Chief Executive of Integrated Guided Missile Development Program. IGMDP. He was responsible for the development and operationalization of Agni and Prithvi missiles. Dr. Kalam was the brain behind India's achievement of becoming a nuclear power. He played pivotal role in India's Pokhran 2 nuclear test in 1998. While still in the mission, he said, "The testing was a defining moment in the country's history. Next only to adopt the path of economic liberalization in 1991. People's President. Dr. Kalam was elected as 11th President of India In July 2002, he became the first scientist to occupy the office of Rashtrapati Bhavan. In the next 5 years, the missile man of India demonstrated his abilities as a true people's president or even children's president. Dr. Kalam has been an inspirational figure for everyone, whether a child, youth or adult. His intention was to make Rashtrapati Bhavan a people's place. He asked every person who worked in Rashtrapati Bhavan to address him as Dr. Kalam and not His Highness or Mahamahim. He became the first president to visit Siachen, the world's highest battleground. Dr. Kalam used his office and post to spread the message of humanity, love, progress and positivity. Kalam insisted on utilizing one's time to the hilt. He himself would never sit idle for a minute. Whenever he found some free time, he would play the veena or write poetry. Our visionary Kalam also initiated e-governance in Rashtrapati Bhavan. Kalam redefined president in unique ways. His instant connect with children, impeccable integrity, simplicity and humanity added to his charm in the eyes of youngsters.
A great teacher, APJ Abdul Kalam's legacy is incomplete without a mention of his role as a teacher. Dr. Kalam was dedicated to teaching and identified himself first as a teacher and then as anything else. Dr. Kalam, in spite of his achievements, always wanted to be remembered as a teacher. What he loved best, spend time among the future of the country and lead them to glory. He said, "Teachers have to realize that they are the builders of the society. The society can be built only when the students are made proficient in their subjects. In addition, they have to provide a vision for life to the students and also inculcate the fundamentals or values which he should practice in the years to come." Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam was also an educationist and often took lectures in profound universities. Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam was the author of 25 inspirational novels. Some of his famous works include Wings of Fire, Ignited Minds, Turning Points, India Vision 2020. He always believed education to be a top priority in a person's life. Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam died of a cardiac arrest while delivering a lecture to the students of IIM Shillong on July 27, 2015. This showed his dedication towards teaching. He leaves behind his legacy of infinite wisdom, thoughtfulness, and intelligence. He was a humanist, one whose constant endeavor was to rise in one's own eyes. Once a student from Jammu and Kashmir asked Kalam, "Would you like to be remembered in history as a great scientist, as a president of India, or as a great teacher?" President Kalam replied, "I want to be remembered as a good human being." Every year, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam's birthday is celebrated with great joy across the country. In 2010, the United Nations had declared October 15 as World Students' Day. Dr. Kalam's personality is an icon of inspiration. He will always be respected for his caliber, qualities, and for his perception about the following: the father, the mother, and the teacher. If a country is to be corruption-free and become a nation of beautiful minds, I strongly feel There are three key societal members who can make a difference. They are the father, the mother, and the teacher. Universe. Look at the sky. We are not alone. The whole universe is friendly to us and conspires only to give the best to those who dream and work. Strength. Climbing to the top demands strength, whether it is to the top of Mount Everest or to the top of your career. Determination. Determination is the power that sees us through all our frustrations and obstacles. It helps in building our willpower, which is the very basis of success. Jai Hind! Jai Hind! Jai Hind!